yo, here we go, yo. Snip, snip here, snip, snip there, and a couple of la-di-da's. Power up the day away in the merry old land of Oz. All right. This is going to be a fun one, y'all. This is going to be a fun one. All right. Now, this is a video I wanted to do, and I apologize. I'm on the mobile. I'm on the mobile, so I won't be able to track the numbers as well for this one. But I promise you the trade is, because I'm not giving out live bonuses during this one, it's because the content is the bonus. Now, what we're going to do real fast in this first session today is I am going to basically top everybody, and we're going to do some fan leaf removal. All right, and this is kind of like a follow-up because one of the videos that I did, the defoliation pruning video, has gotten very popular very fast for a lot of like the younger growers, the beginning growers. People that are just venturing out into this, you know, this world for themselves for the first time. So what you're about to see now is I'm going to start with, I started to write a 10, but it's not. It's the 11. So we're going to start here with the old Casino Kush. I'm going to pull her front and center. I'm gonna do my best to try to give you guys like an idea of how she looks. I'm gonna be moving the camera around as best I can because I want you guys to have an idea, all right? And what you can see literally is there's a definitive line. Hold on, let me stop this airflow on them for a second. All right. And what I want you to see is there's a definitive line. And it's about right here, okay? How old is this plant? This plant was a seed on December 4th of 2018. January, February, March. So we're moving a little bit over 3 months. But you can see that there's a line kind of right in here. So what's going to happen is, whew, that's where we're going to top everything. We're going to top everything right in there, and we're going to defoliate. And I'm going to go ahead and save these tops. And in our second session today, I'm going to basically take the tops. I'm going to take a few seeds. I'm going to take some Grodan blocks, and I'm going to take some Jiffy pellets. And I'm going to show people once again that for clones and propagation, no powders, no gels, no hormones, no nothing. Literally just properly pH'd water at a good temperature, moist substrate, magic happens. All right? The goal here, guys, is to give you the ability to grow more by spending less. All right? And most people think that's because there's some weird reason, like I want you to make more money or something. No, guys, I don't do this because of making money. I do this because of health and happiness. That's why I do it. And I want you guys to be able to do it for the same reasons. But it won't be healthy and happy if you have to spend a ton of money and not get results. So when they have you getting all these products, these gels, hormones, powders, guys, it's an invasive weed species. It will do all of these magical things on its own. And remember this, if you give them a little bit of hardship, all right, if we give them a little bit of hardship, it only works to build their character. All right, it's only gonna make them stronger. It's only gonna make them better in the long run, you understand? So I have my jar here, labeled Casino Kush Monday. That way, if for some reason something happens and I'm unable to do my afternoon sesh or we can't get a feed or whatever, we'll do it tomorrow or when we get to it. But we're going to do this topping and defoliating right now. Now, people always ask me, where do you start? How do you start? Doesn't matter. It's all coming off. So if you know that it's coming off, what I like to do is I like to just reach in and make a dramatic one first. You know what I'm saying? Usually the prettiest, beautifulest, most toppiest, like I just come in and I go, you know what? It's you. It's you. It's you. And then I pinch way down by where I'm gonna snap it at. And I look in and I go, all right, is there some nodes nearby there? There is. Yep. So let's just do that. And then I come in and I pop it. And then I put it down in the jar. And then I just continue on. Yep, right here, yep. And then I pop it like it's hot. And then I come over here. Oh, yep, right here, you too. Casino Kush, you'll be a bush. If you keep growing, I be knowing that your trichomes will be forever glowing. Now, okay, so I've kind of got a decent haircut across the top. Now, this is where after I defoliate, I'll have a better look at the plant, and I'll decide once and for all where the final top's gonna be, if that makes sense. So let me get y'all. Plus, we also gotta clean out some of this larfy, snarfy narf down here. But, let the defoliation begin. Once again, anywhere there is a fan leaf that connects to the main stem, all right? Anywhere you have a fan leaf connecting to a main stem, and then you have a node there that is already producing more fan leaves, well then guess what? You don't need this guy anymore. All that's doing is creating shade, and the plant can adjust. That's what these are for, and that's what new growth will be for. But right now, we want to get maximum light penetration. And we want the plant to continue to stay in a state of growth. All right? So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna start removing the heck out of all these fan leaves. Now, once again, they have to be independent though. Stay, phone, stay. There we go. So you trying to be little Miss Independent? Nope. Now, there's some people that would also tell you to save these leaves. You can juice them and whatnot, and because we haven't used any foliar sprays, and we've used no pesticides or anything like that, another reason I like to do things the way I do them is because I didn't become a fan of foliar feeding until I was doing outdoor and the greenhouse stuff, and I see the benefits of it, but honestly, for me, anytime I can avoid spraying anything on the leaves, even if I know it's just a foliar feed, I would rather avoid it. That's just my personal preference. The plant can get just as healthy without a foliar feed. Preventatives can be used without ever adding them to the plant.
be surprised what a good deep cleaning of the room with some peppermint oil will do. I think of that first scene in the movie The Union, when they show the light and the leaf fluttering in it, and the music's playing. Yeah, I watch way too many weed movies. Yeah, baby girl, come here. Oh, let me get that. Let me get that. Oh, you too, baby girl. Oh, yeah, you too. And see, another thing you'll find is as you get in here and start removing things, you'll find these little guys, these little inner limbs that somehow manage to, like, send shoots up. Why? Because of all the topping and things we've done before. That's what I always tell people. I top the obvious, then I defoliate, and then I go back and look and see where I can train. You know what I'm saying? In other words, you wouldn't go and get your scalp inspected, all right, or get your skull read if you had a whole full head of hair. You know, you would want to give whoever's doing that, like, the opportunity to see everything, get as much information as possible. And that's why I do all the defoliating first before I really go in and do the training and the adjusting of the limbs, so that each and every one of these can potentially be its own top. And that's why I don't immediately remove these inner thin guys that have made it to the top, because obviously they're doing something right. In the fight for supremacy, for them to be able to come from down here and get up in here amongst the big boys, something's right. But also at the same time, you have to make those decisions about that bottom growth. And there's always going to be some snarfy snarfs that have to go.
Snarf, snarf, snarfy snarf. Gotta get rid of that snarfy snarf.
Boom. Like I said, don't be scared. As you remove more and more, you'll find more and more to remove. If that makes sense. Don't be afraid. We've done this years and years and years and years. There's multiple videos of me doing this exact process. And I can assure you that I have not in a decade, a little bit of, I'm pretty sure this channel started, what, 2008? And ever since I've started doing this pruning and defoliating, and even before that, not once has a plant died after me doing this. Not once. And to be quite truthful, a few times, I've literally tried to kill the plant. I have literally reduced a plant all the way down to where I had 8 or 9 stalks completely stripped, and I left one little tiny snarfy leaf down here. One petiole. Why? Because that's all it takes. That's all it takes, people. Let's see here. Let me get in here. Come here, you. Oh, got you. Got you, baby girl. Don't worry, I ain't done yet. I'm gonna get you all good. Daddy is getting a little hot here. I'm gonna have to unleash my hair on everybody. It's like I tell people, if you're not giving your plants the proper nutrition, then this process will expose that and will hopefully help you to get on path. Snarfy snarf. snarfy snar. And it's weird because sometimes when you turn the plant, it helps you to get angles on other leaves that you don't see when you're looking at it from the other side. It's weird. It's weird how it works sometimes. I want to show you guys something because this is also the plant. Remember when we were doing this the first time and it got damaged? Remember where the stalk broke off? That was where that happened. And it's just fine. In fact, it's really sticky there. Woo! I don't know if my ability to hold the phone there was good enough for you guys, but I'll watch the replay later and we'll see what's up. Snarfy, snarf, you gotta go. I thought you'd survive, but that ain't so. You gotta go, snarfy, snarf, you gotta go, you gotta go. Yep. Sometimes you just gotta make that executive decision. And I realized that with this casino kush and this nice, you know, leaf structure, that these inner limbs right here, these little shorties, these thinnies, they don't stand a chance. They're not gonna be able to run with the big dogs. So we're just gonna go ahead and give them the axe now. There's no point in letting the plant put any more energy towards them when we already know that we're gonna be doing what we can to remove. Man, that's an executive decision right there. Gotta think about it. I know you were thinking you were about to get cut right there and you're not sure why I didn't. But it's rare, right? It's rare that I hold a limb and then don't snip if I look at it funny. But I have a feeling once again that I need to do the whole tree before I make a decision on you. So that's why you're living right now. That's why I didn't cut you yet. Once again, I also tell people and remind you, whenever you're defoliating and pruning, if you end up with material falling down into the top of your pots, you know, there's some people that say, oh, it doesn't matter. Oh, that's cool. You know, whatever. It's not cool. It's not cool. Remove it. Anytime you have dead vegetation and decomposing vegetation, it's inviting pests. And inviting predators of those pests, and predators of those predators, and then more pests. So it's better just to not deal with it. It's better just to nip it in the bud. Or nip it during veg, as I like to say. All right. So you get in here. You do some defoliating. Why? Man, sometimes it's just the process. Gotta love the process. You hear that all the time, love the process. If you don't fall in love with the process, well, you damn sure ain't gonna love the destination or appreciate it. Holy business. Let's see here. All right. So, I get in here. I remove about, Sorry, lady. You gots to go. Alright guys, this Casino Kush is coming right along. People always ask, how much can I defoliate? How much? Like what's too much? What's enough? How do I know? Well, you don't. Man, executives suck. You got to go. And see, as you turn more and more times around, I just keep removing. And see, the best part too is also you're able to see literally as you're going along, you're able to just watch the light penetrate. Somebody try to interrupt my flow. All right, let's see. I think you... No. And see, once you get everything into a spot where you're comfortable with it, that's when you can go in and really, really start building and creating a canopy, because you can start seeing what's going to be where. Oh, almost did it again. Same joint. I just popped the same joint. Yep, that's right. I did. I popped the same joint. And you're thinking to yourself, why would you do that to me in the same spot? Man. All right.
Now, let's take a look. And as soon as I slide her back into the spot, you'll get a better idea. So when people ask, how much can you defoliate? Well, let me give you a good idea. There's that much here, and it all used to be over there. And I'm gonna tell you right now that there is easily 65%, two thirds here easily. But it's honestly closer to about 75, 80%, if not more. So that's how that goes down. And what I'm gonna do is I do the same thing. We're gonna do the same thing now for the lavender. This is my girl right here though. This is my girl right here. Now, we got our label. Oh, baby, I love you. You know what's coming, don't you? You saw her get it. I'm gonna get you good, though. I'm gonna get you good, but it's for your best. It's for your best. You feel me? Yeah, I know. I've chosen that spot right there to start. You cool? You ready? All right, here we go. Let me tell you something. When they stinking it up in veg, pew, pew, macho, macho man. I think the macho man. Ooh, one, two. Ooh, that's a good spot. You agree? You agree? I do too, baby girl. I do too. I mean, she's mad at me. Don't get me wrong, guys. Like, she's mad right now. But honestly, she's loving this because she knows, and as you can see, that index finger stalk, she knows what happens right after we do this. Don't you, baby girl? You know the bounce back is real. I'm not going to lie. I'm going to probably get a lot of good lavender foams from this, which is always a good thing.
Shit, I don't know how much I can fit in there. These things are bushy. Smaller one down in there. There you go, baby. Holy goodness. You got to go, too. Nice. Very nice. All right, so as you can see, we kind of got our tops, but the lavender definitely is one of the plants that I love the most because once it flowers, there's way more calyx than there is leaf. What does that mean? That means literally this plant prunes itself. And it's because these fan leaves are so easy to identify. Now, there'll be a lot of them during vegetative growth, but once you flower, if you're pruning and defoliating, the lavender is one of my favorites because it literally is so easy to trim when it's done. Now, this session is going to take a little bit, but as you'll see, if you just get in and get moving, before you know it, you'll start to see parts of her that you didn't know existed. And I just keep spinning and clipping and spinning and clipping. And spinning and spinning and clipping and spinning and spinning. Man, this girl is healthy. Guys, there's so much inner growth in here that when we do this and we're done, the explosion that's going to take place. Good healthy leaves, good healthy undersides, no signs of pests, no signs of larvae or any sign of destruction. One of the reasons I love the lavender, pest resistant. Daya-san, make picture. So much fun, guys. So much fun. I apologize that I'm not as talkative to you guys. Right now, I'm speaking telepathically to my girl right here, letting her know everything's gonna be okay. letting her know that even though I'm putting a serious beating on her, it's for her own good. The good news is the plants in my garden understand that I always have their best interests. I'm always willing to sacrifice so that they don't have to. They know. That's why they trust me. So fine. She's so fine. Do-lang. Definitely gonna be some snarfy snarfs in here. Hopefully you guys are able to see what's going on. I mean, obviously from start to finish, I know you gotta be able to see the results. All right, so we got a lot of little guys in there. I'm gonna, another pro tip about the lavender. The fan leaves are very easy to identify. Because at a certain stage, when the fan leaves get to a certain size, they'll start to get a slight purpling. It's not necessarily, some people think, oh, it's a deficiency, it's this. No, with the lavender, that's just her way of letting you know that that power plant is good, it's full, it's maximized, there's no struggle there. And it's honestly a sign, an indicator that you can get rid of it. And what I tell people is with the lavender, if you see a red or a purple stem, remove it. Remove it. Why? Just try me, test me. And where you remove that from, I guarantee you within a couple days, there's gonna be two new ones there. Man, these air roots are crazy right now. I always like to agitate my topsoil every, you know, the top of the soil. It just helps when you water to get the water to penetrate. Holy cow. I underestimated the strength of this lavender. She's been going crazy. Key, guys, is just don't be scared. I mean, the one thing you gotta understand is this: once you cut something, you can't stick it back on there, but at the same time, you don't necessarily need to be too worried about it, because why? Man, it'll bounce back in some way, shape, or form. It'll bounce back, especially since we're in vegetative growth. Because I know at some point someone's going to come along and make some silly comments and forget the fact that this is done in vegetative growth. I would never ever do this in flower. Now I might do it in week one or two, but once you get into full-on flower, nah. That's right. You had to go, baby girl. Sorry. I know you didn't see it coming, but you should have. And here's the thing, guys. When you prune and defoliate and you get rid of stuff, you'll notice spots in the plant where no matter how often you prune and defoliate, there just seems to be a reason that certain areas bounce back more than others. Don't worry about it. Don't question it. Don't overthink it. Just know that it happens. Just know that it happens. All right. Getting to that home stretch. But I can start to tell it's only going to be like one or two more spins of the plant. Another thing I love about the lavender is just the bounce back. Because it's like no matter how much you beat her up, she just finds a way to bounce back. And not only does she bounces back strong. Like there's growth everywhere in this thing, guys. And you guys saw the beatdowns I give them. You guys know the beatdowns I give. Like I take my plants to the edge. Why? I want them to build character. I want them to know they can overcome anything as long as we work together. You guys might not be able to hear it right now, but I can promise you that if you could hear it, the lavender plant right now is singing, "I'm not afraid." Well, y'all can't hear it, but I can hear it. I'm not afraid to take the clip, to take the clip, cause I know that I'm the shit. I'll bounce back even stronger. See, y'all can't hear it, but I can hear it. Man, I'm gonna have to get an overhead look on this girl. Cause she's filled out everywhere. That's when you know it's serious, when you gotta get the overhead helicopter look. Like traffic copter 6 up here. Yeah, we have a traffic jam in the central area of the plant. The backup should be stopped immediately. Who should resume? obviously every day for the next couple days, we're gonna be feeding them. Giving them that love and affection that they need so that they can bounce back. As you can see, I am definitely giving them a thorough haircut. Nice. You like that? You like that, didn't you, Labby? You sly little girl, you. I know how you like it. I know how you like it. Oh, yeah. She just did the Kool-Aid sound. Oh, yeah. Now this next couple feeds is going to be important because the bounce back, in order for it to be real, we have to make sure that we provide every single bit of nutrition that we can possibly. We're going ham. And guys, I've realized that sometimes I look at something and I go, oh man, you look so beautiful with two or four heads on you. And then I'll cut it off because I go, well, if you look good with two or you look good with four, imagine what you're going to look like with eight. Bam. Ooh, you didn't like that one. Until you see what I'm doing with it. Until you saw what I was going to do. And now you know, yeah? See? Trust me, baby girl. Trust me, I got you. All right, so this is gonna be kind of cool. All right, so look at that. I can assure you that we have removed probably 75%, if not more. You can see the structure. For those of you that follow me on the gram, you remember all those lines in the picture I drew? Well, now you see it. We also have our lavender, our casino kush, and if you join me again, when I come back later on, I'm gonna actually go ahead, we're gonna do some rock wool, we're gonna do some clips and clones into rock wool, I'm gonna soak some pellets, we're gonna do some seed propagation, and we're gonna do it all again with no gels, hormones, powders, or any of that stuff.
But we're gonna go ahead and bang this all out and get it done. Hopefully I'm able to get another live stream with notifications out. But you can now see good, clean structure. We're keeping them all in that range to where they're knee high, between thigh and knee. Fill them out. That way when we flower them, they'll go belly button to nipple high and they'll just fill out with just donkey dicks. You'll have those big old fat colas like this, and it'll look like a bunch of big old donkey hard-ons sticking up in your garden. But hopefully these pruning and defoliating videos are helping you guys and giving you the ability to go into your gardens and do the same thing. We just got to make sure now we give them good, constant nutrition, and you'll see the bounce back. I'm going to go ahead and wrap this up, and I'll see you guys in a couple hours. I'm not sure what time it is right now, but I'm going to go ahead and get myself something to eat. And then when I get back, boom, we're going to go ahead, and we're going to go ahead and handle these. And we'll go ahead and put a couple seeds in some pellets and some Grodan so that people could see what's up. Do I still water, feed? No. At this stage in the game, because they're processing, I'm giving them each a gallon a day, and they're getting a gallon a day with food. Especially the next 3 days with this one. They're getting a gallon a day with food and a little bit of Super Thrive. But don't worry, I'll show you that tomorrow. But for now, we're gonna go ahead and wrap this up, and I'll see you guys in a little bit. We'll put some clones into some rock wool, into some pellets, and we'll put some seeds in as well so people can see cloning and some propagation. Yes, they're a little naked, but don't worry, they'll bounce back. The bounce back is real. All right, everybody.